Hello friends, welcome back. Today's topic is equivalent single wheel load. Before starting the topic ESWL, I would like to clear some of the things. So here in this figure, it is shown is the vehicle tire. If two vehicle tires are interconnected, it is called as the axle. So here vehicle is having the dual wheel axle connection. So instead of using the single wheel, if you use dual wheel load assembly, it have a certain advantage, so that here the contact area between the vehicle tire and pavement surface will be more compared to the single axle, so that we can reduce the load on the pavement as well as stress on the pavement. So equivalent single wheel load in a heavy vehicle, rear axle in general have two wheels at one side instead of single wheel. Here pressure at certain depth below cannot be obtained by numerically adding the pressure caused by each wheel load. So equivalent single wheel load is used. It is the single wheel having the same contact pressure which produce same value of maximum stress, deflection and contact pressure at a desired depth as two individual wheel produce. So here two wheels are having the load as P and small d is the clear gap between the inner side of two wheels. S is the center to center distance between the two wheels, and up to a distance d by 2 there is no overlapping of stress. Okay, each wheel load P will be acting separately, so at a distance d by 2 the stresses starts overlapping. Certain assumptions are made for the calculation of ESWL. So first one is the contact area between the vehicle tire and pavement surface is considered as a circular, and influence angle is taken as 45 degree, and soil is isotropic, nothing but the substance having the physical property which has the same value when measured in different directions, and soil is considered as a homogeneous composed of parts or elements that are all of same kind, and soil is considered as a elastic, nothing but the material able to resume its original shape spontaneously after being stretched or compressed. Overlapping of stress is effective in between the distance d by 2 to 2s. So up to distance or a depth d by 2, overall stress is equivalent to stress due to tire 1 as well as stress due to tire 2, and after depth 2s, overall stress will be equal to stress due to tire 1 and stress due to tire 2. In this figure, the 2a is the diameter of the contact area, so that small a is the radius of contact area and small d is distance between the inner side of two wheel, and s is center to center distance between the two tires, and p is the each wheel load. So here in this figure you can see here up to a distance d by 2 each wheel load P is acting individually. So at a approximately point at a distance of d by 2 the stresses started to overlap. So here to draw the graph we use two points, one is point A and other one is point B. So point A nothing but which is having at a depth of d by 2 means, so where the vehicle tire pressure is taken as P because up to distance d by 2 there is no overlapping of stresses. So after the distance d by 2 the stresses starts overlapping. That's why the coordinates of another point B is taken as 2s and P plus P will be taken as 2P. So in this figure it is shown a graphical representation for finding the ESWL value. So here mainly we need to locate point A and point B in a log-log sheet. Okay, the x-axis is taken as depth set in terms of mm or centimeter, and y-axis is taken as single wheel load factor. So here log-log graph is required to find the ESWL value. First we need to locate the point A which is having the coordinates P and D by 2. So using the value P and D by 2 in a log-log graph, we need to locate the point A. Similarly, point B should be located using two coordinates 2P and 2s. Okay, once we locate point A and point B, we need to join point A and B by a straight line. If you want to find the ESWL value, that is P1, at a depth of Z1, okay, first on a x-axis locate the value Z1 at which you need to find the equivalent V load factor. So after locating the point Z1, so draw a straight line where it touches, project towards the ESWL, means project towards the y-axis, so that you can find the respective P1 value. P1 is the equivalent single V load value at a depth of Z1. So this is the simple graphical presentation which is used to find the ESWL value. Thank you.